Now we're now joined by Albay Governor Grex Lagman. Governor Lagman, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen, and happy 125th Independence Day. Good morning.
All right, same to you, sir. Can you give us an overview of what's happening right now in Albay?
Okay, we got reports from VVox that within the day, it's possible that we would be raising the alert level from 3 to 4 because of the new lava dome that has been spotted at the crater of Mayon. And at present, we have 3,761 families. This amounts to 13,348 persons who are presently evacuated in our various evacuation sites in the province.
I'm curious, the 13,500 people, roughly speaking, now that estimate, do they live within the 6-kilometer danger zone?
Yes, that's the reason why they were evacuated. They live in within that 6-kilometer danger zone radius.
Okay.
And
No, I spoke with VVox, I think, last week, and they said, ideally speaking, nobody should even be living. That's why it's called the danger zone. Has this been a challenge for you, Governor? Were there efforts to actually look for different locations for these families?
Yes. You know, Karen, that's a question that has been posed to me by many media partners. And I think the best time to answer that would be right after things normalize, because we have to convince some LGUs, because it's within their power to actually look into the possibility of perhaps dissolving some barangays that are really very vulnerable. It's a political issue question, really, Karen. So at this point, we do not like to deal with those issues. We want to first respond accordingly. We want our efforts to be in line with that of the national governments. But that issue on the presence of some barangays within the 6-kilometer danger zone should be addressed eventually.
Okay. Governor, can you just expound a bit? Why is it more of a political issue? Considering this is not the only issue in the Philippines where something's quite clear and yet implementation on the ground is different. Why has this turned into a political issue?
The political issue that I just mentioned is about the process that has to be followed whenever some LGUs like barangays need to be dissolved, because this problem is not dissimilar. It's very aptly similar to what's happening in urban areas when people live under bridges, when they live in very dangerous portions of the city, the parts of the city that actually contribute to urban blight. It's the same. So what I think what should happen is that we should have a dialogue on this matter. And LGUs, the LCEs of the LGUs concerned should be open to the possibility of actually coming up with an ordinance, because it would start with an ordinance, to actually look into the possibility of, dissolving the barangays, but of course, with proper interventions, proper resettlement, proper planning with respect to employment, etc.
All right. Now, the province of Albay was placed under a state of calamity last week. And
yes.
What does this mean really for the province? How much funding can you be able to move and use with a province being under a state of calamity?
Yes. Last June 8, I wrote the SPA, the Sangguniang Panlalawigan, to actually declare a state of calamity last June 9, and they did with alacrity. And at present, it has already legally armed me with the right to actually disburse our quick response fund in the amount of 30 million pesos. So that is what we're looking at. It's a measly amount, because our projections show that it will only last for like 15 to 20 days.
Wow.
It's good that the SWD Secretary Rex Gatchalian has committed to actually defray the logistics for the first 5 cycles. It will amount to 15 days for the delivery of family food packs for the evacuees. But of course, the province is also planning to do more in terms of providing trainings, test the trainings, for example, for the evacuees. We also plan to put up Wi-Fi stations so that the education of students who are also evacuees would continue. And we also plan to purchase vegetables from farmer organizations and associations to also give the same to our evacuees. Para meron po silang ginagawa, a certain degree of normalcy must be achieved.
Okay, and right now with over 13,000 people that's evacuated, is the government, is the provincial government already using the calamity funds?
Not yet, Karen. Okay. We have yet to actually plan this out more thoroughly to make sure that the money would be spent in the most efficient way possible.
Mm. I spoke with FEVOX last week, and they were optimistic that there may not be an eruption like that of 2018, because they claim that there were technical terms used, but in effect, the mouth of the volcano wasn't as open as, let's say, in 2018, which would then be a sign for a full eruption. And the magma flow within the volcano, they didn't spot any. They had a specific term, but new magma flowing that would cause it to erupt or full blown. So what are you seeing right now?
We actually base our actions on the reports of FEVOX. Okay. And as I've said earlier, what will happen, what the possibility of actually increasing the radius would coincide with the FEVOX advisory. For example, if the FEVOX tells us to actually raise the same to alert level 4, then the radius would increase from 6 to 7 kilometers. This would mean more evacuees need to be evacuated from their homes.
And they need to be supported too.
Yes, of course. And we have the logistics for that. The Provincial Engineering Office has already provided trucks to actually transport our evacuees to evacuation centers. And there are some enterprising mayors that have actually undertaken an innovative a measure wherein the farmers can still actually work. And then the barangay captain would just make sure that after working hours, they will be again brought back to the evacuation centers. Okay. Because we don't want a total drastic change in their lifestyle, Karen, even as we make sure that their health and safety remain paramount.
Oo. Actually, matindi nga po ang pinagdadaanan ng the Bicol region in general, no? So right now, you are facing the possible eruption of Mayon. Pero binabagyo din kayo. Matindi kayo, dinadaanan din kayo ng ulan. Are you still reeling from damages coming from previous typhoons?
Yes, the typhoons in 2020, of course, Ulysses, Quinta, and Raleigh, many funding for the damages are brought about by said typhoons are yet to be actually implemented. So nasa OCD po yung mga funding for that. And I'm happy that tomorrow, OCD Administrator Nepomuceno Ariel will be here. And later today, DILG Secretary Benner Abalos will be visiting us as well. And I have invited all the mayors for a dialogue with him so that he would be able to actually look into the situation on the ground. Perhaps he would plan to go around the evacuation centers.
Okay.
To personally check.
Well, generally speaking, it's good that they're going, but why is it that funding is this delayed? The release of the funding, it's already 2023.
That's how the budget process works, Karen. It's beyond our power to actually, but we're doing everything actually to expedite the same. I think local chief executives like myself have that persuasive power to make sure that the funding arrives as soon as possible.
All right.
Or is used as soon as possible.
Yeah. Is there anything else you'd like to add? Do you need any kind of assistance, Governor?
Yes, I would like to make sure that the president has already committed to me to help. And I asked him for cash assistance because ayaw po natin ng mga lagi na lang po tayo dun sa kahon, di kahon ng mga pag-interventions. Like even as they're evacuated inside the evacuation centers, pwede naman po sila bigyan ng cash assistance yung ating mga evacuees para po yung economy natin hindi naman po maantala. They can still buy from our stores outside, from the market, para po tuloy-tuloy. Ayaw po namin ng dole-outs dito sa Albay. And ang gusto po namin dito are innovative means or measures para naman hindi naman lagi na lang the usual way of doing things ang mangyayari pag may evacuation. And I want to commend the Albayanos for being so cooperative when it comes to evacuation. Dito sa Albay, Karen, I would say that second nature na po sa aming mga Albayano to respond accordingly to calls for preemptive evacuation. Wala masyadong resistance, and I'm happy to note as well that nakakontribute dito yung aming mga evacuation sites for livestock. We cannot discount the fact that farmers are not so excited to be evacuated because andun po yung kanilang kabuhayan, andun po yung kanilang mga baka, di ba, baboy, etc., ruminants. And ang maganda po dito, ready naman po sila, mas active yung kanilang pag-cooperate sa amin kasi alam nila na safe yung kanilang mga animals sa aming mga evacuation sites for livestock.
On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today, Albay Governor Greg Slagman. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Karen.